The most important thing is, in the case of plant pathology, you are going to study different disease. And when you will be studying those disease, a pattern should be followed. Like for example, hello everyone, welcome to Plutus IS. My name is Khushmeet Kaur Hunjan and I will be taking your botany optional. So today in this video, we are going to discuss that how to prepare for botany optional. Okay, so in this video, I'm going to cover these topics, that why botany, why you should go for botany, pattern of the paper, syllabus of the paper, study material and the strategies for preparation as well as for scoring. Okay, so let us start with the first one, that why you should go for botany as an optional subject. Before jumping into that, let's discuss that who all can go for botany. So basically, I would suggest that the people who belong to life sciences field or any allied field of life sciences, for example, if you are from botany, zoology, or even from any allied field, like for example, microbiology, biochemistry, biotechnology. So you all can go for botany, okay? So now let's discuss that what are the pros of taking botany. So first thing which I have written here is easy for life sciences students. So even if you have your biology in your 12th class or in your graduation, it would be very, very easy for you because the basic terminology and the basics are very, very clear to you already. So you will have an upper hand already and it will be comparatively easy for you to crack this particular exam. Okay, the second point is very, very important is that botany has a defined syllabus. Okay. If you will compare the syllabus of botany with other subjects, you will see that the questions are very, very direct and the syllabus is very defined. There are no current affairs you want to keep updated yourself with, nothing like that. The syllabus is very defined. Yes, it is bit longer, I would say. Okay, but the syllabus is very, very defined. And if studied and analyzed in a better manner, it is very, very easy to cover. Okay. So I would say that defined syllabus is one of the greatest advantage of the botany subject. Okay, the next is good availability of resources. Of course, we have resources, study material of all the subjects. But when you will talk about botany, we have really good Indian authors whose books are really, really helpful to us. Okay, even some books that were written by Delhi University teachers are very, very nice, very simplistic, beautiful, simple language. And if you want to clear your basic, you can always start from NCERT. So, and also, if you will join my course and take my classes, so my notes will be really, really helpful, which I will let you make in the class. So there is no scarcity of the resources. So you will be accomplished by the resources that are required to cover this particular subject. Okay, the next is that it will aid in your GS paper. Two subjects. The first one is science and technology. And second part is ecology. Okay, these are the overlapping topics of your botany as well as your GS paper. Okay, so covering these two topics will be overlapping with the preparation of your botany optional. So it is not just have a defined syllabus, but it will also help in your other exams too. Okay, here I have shown you an example. See, these are the questions from the last 10 years, 2015, 14 and 2021. If you will read this question, this question is about biological nitrogen fixation, and along with that, the examiner has asked you about root nodule formation and the role of nitrogenous enzyme. Here also in 2014, the question is related to nitrogen fixation in leguminous plants. In 2015 also, the question is asked of biological nitrogen fixation, emphasis on denitrogenase, that is the enzyme required for nitrogenous fixation. So if you see here clearly, in the span of these 10 years, last 10 years, you have seen this question repeatedly asking in different forms. So the first thing, whenever you are preparing for any exam, the first thing is analyzing the question paper, analyzing the previous year question paper. So you will see a particular pattern is formed in the botany subject and the questions are very, very straight. Like for example, the question will be explain the functions of different type of stomata present in different angiosperms. So very direct, you will just name the stomata present in different angiosperms, and the questions are very direct. There is no scope for a lot of complex conceptuality. that you will do in paper 2 a little bit. But otherwise the questions are very direct, they are very repetitive. So it is very, very important to know the pattern of the paper, to study the PYQs. It will really, really help you in the paper. Okay, so this was just an example. Like these, there are many questions which have a repetitive order or iterative pattern. Okay, so here I have the pattern of the paper. Okay, so if you will see in the question paper, if I talk about paper 1 also or paper 2, you are going to have 8 questions. And among these 8 questions, only 5 questions you have to do. So the choice is great. Yeah, there is one condition, that the first question from section A and the first question from section B are compulsory. So basically 8 questions divided in 2 sections, section A and section B. Aur dono hi sections mein se jo first question hai, it is compulsory. Theek hai? Other than that, you have free choice of 3 questions. Theek hai? 2 compulsory ho gaye. बाकी आप कोई भी इसमें से 3 क्वेश्चंस चूज कर सकते हो. देयर इज जस्ट वन कंडीशन व्हिच आई हैव रिटन हियर, दैट यू हैव टू चूज वन क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम एटलीस्ट वन क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम ईच सेक्शन. लाइक फॉर एग्जांपल, सेक्शन ए में से 1 क्वेश्चन कंपलसरी है, सेक्शन बी में से भी 1 क्वेश्चन कंपलसरी है. अब आपको 3 क्वेश्चन करने हैं, सो आप ये नहीं कर सकते दैट आई विल चूज 2, 3, 4. नो, यू हैव टू चूज एटलीस्ट वन क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम ईच सब्जेक्ट. दैट मीन्स in section A also you have to choose one question at least, and section B also you have to choose one question. ठीक है, मतलब अगर मैं यहाँ पे 6, 7 कर रही हूँ तो मैं 8 choose नहीं कर सकती. I have to choose something from section A. So the lump sum thing is that there are 8 questions and you have to do just 5. And each question carries 50 marks. Here I've drawn the table also, that the number of questions and which one is compulsory and which one is optional. Okay, so 50 marks for one question and you have to do 5 questions. That means your each paper is going to be of 250 marks. You are going to have 2 papers, paper 1 and paper 2, whose syllabus we are going to discuss in subsequent slides. Okay, I hope you are clear with the pattern of the paper. So these are the topics of paper 1 and paper 2. I am really going to discuss it very, very briefly. Okay, the first one is paper 1. This is more on the core side, okay, more factual, more on the something you have to remember. Okay, this paper 2 is more application based, it is more on the conceptual side. Okay, let's discuss. In paper 1 you have microbiology and plant pathology. In microbiology and plant pathology you will study about different microorganisms. In the case of microbiology, like bacteria like organism. You will also go to virus and prion hypothesis also. In the case of plant pathology, you will study pathogenic reactions, interactions, and the most important thing is, in the case of plant pathology, you are going to study different disease. And when you will be studying those disease, a pattern should be followed. Like for example, the causative organism which has caused the disease, okay, the symptoms and the preventive measures, okay. So this type and the control, okay. So this type of, in this pattern, you have to study the pathology part, okay. The next is cryptogams. It is a very, very diverse unit. Why? Because in this you are going to go to the species also. Okay, we will discuss about some specific genera also in this particular topic. And this topic has to be studied like considering the evolutionary point of view. Theek hai? The next is phanerogams, which is the most important unit of this particular paper 1. Everything is important, but this one is very vast and very, very important. In this, you are going to cover taxonomy also, you are going to cover embryology also, and anatomy of angiosperms also, and along with that, 20 families of angiosperms. Okay, so this this unit, because it is diversified so much, this is very, very highly important. In this, the most important part is floral diagrams. Okay, you will start with the morphological part, and you will go till presentation, flower, key arrangement, everything you will cover in this particular topic. Okay, the fourth is plant resource and development. Okay, it is nothing but economic botany. Okay, in this you are going to study the plants, different type of plants, and the best way to study them is grouping them. Okay, how will you study? Like raisin wale plants, gums wale plants. Okay, so you will group the particular plants, so the study will become very, very easy. And don't go for the list which is already made in the book. Go for your own list, your own understanding. Like, okay, I think these plants have this in common, and they should be placed this side. Okay, something like this. Then we have morphogenesis, which is your tissue culture. Okay, so in tissue culture, what you are going to study in tissue culture, basically micropropagation, different techniques. In this paper, only this part is applicable. Okay, in which you are going to study different techniques. Here you will also study about one Indian scientist. See, wherever you are going to study about Indian scientists, always mention them. Okay, here I will tell you about Guha and Maheshwari for the haploid culture. So these things, these Indian scientists specifically, their experiments, it is very, very important. Okay, this is all about paper one. If I talk about paper two, here I have cell biology. In cell biology, you are going to discuss different organelles and try to read all the organelles from the plant point of view. Theek hai, plant organelles ke perspective mein hume zyada padhna hai. Other than that, you are going to study what? You are going to study about cell cycle, the different checkpoints of cell cycle. Then we have genetics, molecular biology and evolution. This unit and this unit are the most vast and most important unit of this particular paper. Okay, genetics is most important. We will start with Mendelian genetics and we will cover up to the modern genetics. Okay, in molecular biology, questions come from your replication, transcription, translation, gene editing, silencing, everything. Okay, so in this topic you have to go in detail and it is a conceptual topic. So I would suggest, if the basics of this topic, this particular topic, is not clear, you can pick up your NCERT and start revising it from your basics. Okay, for covering this particular topic, your basics have to be really, really strong. Okay, so for this topic, start with the basic and then you will be able to understand the conceptual things in this particular topic. Okay, then we have plant breeding, biotechnology and biostatistics. Okay, from this unit we have seen that short notes in the compulsory questions have been very, very prominent. So what you can do, like for example, biostatistics. Okay, we have a chi-square test or significance test. So what you can do, you can prepare short notes on these particular topics, and this is comparatively an easy unit, more applicable base, and you will enjoy doing this particular unit. Okay, now the most important unit, that is physiology and biochemistry. Okay, this is a very vast unit. This is also very, very important unit. Okay, sometimes people find it difficult because of the multiple reactions, but there is a book by a teacher, S.K. Gujral. Okay, that book of plant physiology is very, very wonderful. The cycles are written very, very beautifully, very simplified way. So you can always go for refer that particular book. I have also given the list of the books, so we will discuss in that particular. So this will be something which you have to understand and which needs time. So when you study different cycles, make that cycle in your copies and paste it everywhere so that you see them everywhere. Okay, so other than that, we have ecology and plant geography, which is also overlapping with your GS paper. Here you can go a little bit on the current knowledge, but still it is very, very scoring and very, very easy unit. Okay, so this was the wholesome summary of the syllabus of paper 1 and paper 2. Okay, here are some books which I have referred for bacteria and virus, H.C. Dubey, plant pathology, P.D. Sharma, introduction of botany, A.C. Datta, and lower biology, Singh Pandejan. This you can buy. This is a very, very good book. It has like properly explained everything about the lower organisms. Then embryology, Bhojwani and Bhatnagar, simplified book. Plant taxonomy, Gurucharan Singh is preferred. They have make you understand everything from very, very basic. Okay, so you can go for Gurucharan Singh. O.P. Sharma is also a good option. For economic botany, I would say S.L. Kocher. Then plant tissue culture, we have the standard book, S.S. Bhojwani and Razdan. Okay, cell biology, I would not prefer that you directly go for General Carb, okay, or something like that. You can start from P.K. Verma. It has cell biology as well as genetics. Okay, so start with P.K. Verma. If you want to study in detail, you can go for Carb, but start from P.K. Verma. For genetics, P.K. Verma is also fine, or Stutzen and Snustert and Simpsons is something which you can prefer. For plant breeding, Kudan Singh is one of the really nice book. Okay, then for biostatistics, I have Veerwala Rastogi. Okay, for plant physiology and development, I have various options here. The first one is S.L. Kocher and S.K. Gujral. This is the book I was talking about. My teacher has wrote this book and this is very, very nice book, very simplified. It is also preferred in Delhi University. Okay, then we have a very amazing book, Hopkins and Tiaz. Okay, all the physiological concepts has been really, really wonderfully described in these particular books. Okay, so you should definitely, like, after learning the basics, understanding the concepts, you should definitely go for these books. Read these books, okay? Biotechnology, we have B.D. Singh, and for ecology, we have P.D. Sharma and O.P. Sharma as well. Okay? So, let's talk about the strategy and planning for this particular paper. So, the first point which I have written here is analyzing the P by Qs. As I've already mentioned, whenever you are preparing for some paper, the first thing is to know that what the examiner wants from you. Okay, so you have to go through the paper first. You have to analyze the question paper. For you, what I do is, whenever I teach in my class, before any unit, I give you a list of 20, last 20 year questions from that particular topic. Okay, so have me in those PDFs. So it will be very, very easy for you to understand that from this particular topic, what the examiner wants to know from you, which kind of questions you are supposed to ask. So analyzing the PYQs will be very, very helpful because see, the syllabus is very vast. The units are very huge. So you have to be concise, you have to be smart. Yes, hard work is necessary, but smart work is what you have to add into the table, okay? The next is concept clarity. As I have told you, there are some papers in unit 2, paper 2 as well, and paper 1 also. You should be crystal clear with your concept because you can bring anything to the table or you can write answers when you have clear clarity about that particular topic. So your concept clarity should be there and there is no shame. If you want to clear your concept, please start with the basic. Go for NCRT, read your NCRT first. You should be thorough with your NCRT and then move to further books. Okay, reproducibility. By this, I mean that whenever you are studying a topic, whenever you are studying something or learning something, okay, the answer should be such that you can reproduce it on time. Like for example, अगर मैंने कोई टॉपिक पढ़ा सो दैट शुड बी इन अ सीक्वेंस मैनर दैट आई विल राइट दिस आई विल राइट दिस आई विल राइट दिस बिकॉज यू विल हैव अ कंसाइज पॉइंट ऑफ टाइम इन द पेपर सो द आंसर शुड बी रिप्रोड्यूसेबल ऑन द शीट्स दैट इज वॉट इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर यू अल्टीमेटली राइटिंग द आंसर इज इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर यू ओके आई विल टेल यू ट्रिक्स ऑल्सो इन द लेटर क्लासेज दैट हाउ कैन यू राइट योर आंसर्स वेरी वेरी एफिशियंटली बट फॉर नाउ यू हैव टू रिमेंबर दिस देन वी हैव रिविजन सी इन बायोलॉजी यू हैव टू रिमेंबर अ लॉट ऑफ थिंग्स Like for example, in paper 1, cryptograms, phanerograms, the information is a lot, okay? So you have to keep revising those things because you cannot just read something once and just leave it, okay? So keep revising things, revise it at least 3-4 times. It will be very, very efficient and as well as useful for you, okay? Never skip your revisions, do it multiple times. Then we have consistency. See, whenever we talk about hard work, consistency comes with it, right? See, for your botany paper, if you are through with your concept, if you are through with your basics, you can give just 3 hours per day. And these 3 hours are very, very necessary. Okay, dedicate your 3 hours per day. And for some day, if you don't have 3 hours, you have 2-1, give it. Don't skip any day. Each day will be like your building blocks for the botany paper. Okay, so consistency is very, very important. Read your botany books, read your textbooks, go through your notes every day. Even not notes, make cycles, make your diagrams, be efficient with whatever you are doing, okay? Don't skip any day, be consistent for this paper, okay? Now, the strategy, the last topic is that how can you score decent, okay? Certain things and certain factors which you can include to be efficient to score decent. See, what is a decent score? 300 plus is considered to be a decent score, right? So how you can score 300 plus in your exams? The first is illustrations. That means wherever it is required, please write illustrations, make flowcharts, make tables. Okay, for the examiner also, it is very, very easy that they are getting the whole picture of the answer in a particular table or in a particular flowchart. Okay, illustrate the name of the scientist also. Mention the name of the scientist also. Especially whenever you are reading, wherever there is an Indian scientist, highlight it twice, thrice. Okay, because never skip them. It is very, very important. Okay, so illustrations are the key. You can illustrate your answer very, very efficiently. Then diagrams. Okay, when we talk about biology, diagrams come along with it, right? So beautiful diagrams can fetch you marks. Neat diagrams, neat labelings. It does not have to be a boundary around it, but a very neat diagram, well labeled on one side. So these type of things can fetch you marks. Okay. Presentation skills. Presentation skills means you can use different colors. You can make points. You can highlight your points. Just don't use a red color. Other than that, you can go for different colors. highlight your points, okay, write in points and use different colors for like scientist name, okay, you can use different color for the scientist name or for something, some feature. See, the examiner is looking for certain words in your question, in your answer, okay? So whenever you're writing that answer and you know these words are very, very important, you should definitely go and highlight them. It makes the work of examiner very, very easy. When they open your question paper, they see, okay, the answer sheet, sorry, they see that the person has written this word also, he or he has mentioned this also. So it becomes easy for them also, and for you also, it works as a plus-plus. Okay, and the last and the most important point is your expression. See, everyone is going to study the same topic, same books, everything is same. But what you, yourself, your understanding, that matters. Like for example, we are going to study different cycles. We are going to study different cycles of respiration, photosynthesis, a lot of cycles we are going to study. Okay, how can you combine them? How can you link them? What you are bringing to the table, what is your expression, how can you express whatever is your answer, what is the understanding of the concept in your mind, that will eventually matter. Okay, so this you can do by writing answers. I'm not saying that you have to write answers from day one. Notes you have to prepare for day one. Okay, from day one you have to write your notes, but for answers, wait for a month, okay, analyze everything, understand the topic fully, and then start writing answers. First read answers, learn answers, and then within a span of 1 month, you will be efficient, or I would say you will be good in writing the answers, and you will be able to write the answers of the question, and you can solve the PPIQs. Okay, so this was all about the video. I hope that it was helpful to you. Okay, thank you.